That your call?
Mm-hmm.
You can start the show.
Oh my god, they start the show!
She gave them the okay! Phone lady gave them the okay!
Oh my god.
Phone lady hype!
I think they were showing off Fallout 76.
I don't... There it is! Woo!
Like
2011, they are. Oh, that's not too ahead of me. I remember one E3, this dude was saying stuff that was like 5 seconds ahead. He was calling out the games before they were even shown. Like, he didn't know any better.
I was using my ability.
Please welcome Bethesda's global senior vice president.
I'm actually just out here eating Hershey Kisses for no reason.
Actually, Todd Howard's hell. Oh yeah. Unless he rude.
All right.
Thank you.
And I hope all the audio is all right, ladies and gentlemen. Let me know if I need to turn the Discord or the stream up.
You sound good. I love you too. You look good. You guys ready to go?
Bring out Todd, the big guns.
And I'm delighted to be back on stage.
Dude, trust me, he was here for Microsoft. He'll be here for this.
Now, we've got all kinds of surprises in store for you tonight. So whether you're here with us in the audience or you're one of the millions who are watching around the world, settle in, get ready for the very best in gaming.
Skyrim plus new funky mode. Let's go.
Create, and it's a theme embraced by our 10 studios spread around the globe, the incredibly talented folks who make the Bethesda games that you'll soon be playing. But as you saw in our intro video, it's not just developers. Everyone at Bethesda is a part of the team that brings our games to life, and that extends to all of you.
That's literally a bunch of numbers. How do you remember how to log in, my dude?
Adventures, stories, and experiences, and it's your passion for games that drives us every day to strive for excellence.
All right. Bungo, we are not doing this shit again. Every time they showed off a game, it's like, all right, that's cool and all, but where's Left 4 Dead?
Games like Prey, Dishonored, Death of the Outsider, The Evil Within 2, Wolfenstein 2. We even released exciting updates for The Elder Scrolls Online. We brought full open world VR with Fallout 4 and Skyrim, plus Doom VFR, and we even released our first two games for the Nintendo Switch. So we were thrilled when Metacritic named us the top publisher in the industry with the highest overall review scores across all of our games.
All right, now win E3 real quick.
Tonight is about the future. We're here to show you where we're headed and the games that we're creating that you'll soon be playing, the worlds that you'll be inhabiting in the next year and beyond. So, we're starting with a game that we announced a few weeks ago through our friends at Walmart Canada.
What? Wait, did someone leak something?
Perhaps best known for their low prices and ability to keep a secret.
So wait, what leak?
Started with a look at Rage 2.
Wait.
I thought that leaked it. I think.
And this is something I love about Bethesda. They don't give a shit.
That's funny. Oh, it was Walmart Canada that leaked it?
Yeah, Walmart Canada apparently leaked the game and the low price or something.
All right! My name's slogan is like low prices.
Wait, Walmart Canada leaked about 20 games for Bethesda and Ubisoft? Are you serious? When did that happen? I missed that.
I said, are you ready to rage?
So what is happening right
now? What about you? You ready to rage?
Rock Band?
E3, I thought we were over. Nope. Ourselves.
Oh,
Okay. Y'all want to just stop though? Like,
okay. I'm here to watch video games.
What happens when you're only knowing?
Look at her!
Look at her! She's just like, ah! Oh. That lady is my spirit animal.
Bethesda, I love you, please.
So, for everyone who was here during the Microsoft press conference, you know I do a rating scale a lot differently than most other people who cover this stuff. So, everyone starts off at a perfect 10. Rather than 0 and working their way up, they start at 10 and they work their way down. Every time something stupid happens, they lose a point. If they do something uncrazily real that is beyond words, that is so positive that they get a bonus point back, they can get it back. As of now, they're starting at an 8.5. They lose a point and a half for this. I'm sorry.
Yeah, okay, wait. Consider this. Yeah, 2 points back just because of some... One, I get to see... Two, I get our new one announced. And three, the cringe comps.
Alright, I'm being corrected by a couple people. Saying that it should be like -2 or -3. I'm giving them their point back for loud capping the fuck out of Canada Walmart. They deserve a little something just for that. Come on.
I don't seem into that at all.
I think they're applauding that it's over.
Probably. All right.
Let's give it up again for Andrew WK, the perfect song we'll for Rage 2.
That's Todd Howard.
Hi everyone, my name is Tim Willits, and I am the studio director at ID Software.
They could have had the live music, I would have been fine with that, but like, they didn't even show off a trailer to go along with it, man. Like, that was just.
We're here to say
that's my problem.
Rage is back. Now, we had a ton of crazy ideas when we started planning Rage 2. And we needed the right studio to bring our vision to life. Mm-hmm. Now, we've admired the open world chaos in all of Avalanche Studios games. And as we're about to show you, they delivered big time.
Ha ha, he's tall, he's big, it's funny.
Don't bully him.
Well, thank you, Tim.
I like this guy.
Yeah. Well, speaking for everyone at Avalanche Studios, this is really a dream to come true for us. The World of Rage 2 is perfect for our style of gameplay. But even more exciting than that has been to work with these guys at ID Software. These guys invented the first-person shooter.
Good day now.
And they still make the best shooters out there.
I mean, technically.
So it's been a really great collaboration. To bring
random
you
trivia
the most
with an answer I don't know.
World shooter
what was the first person?
Played?
The first person shooter.
So Rage 2 transports players into a dystopian future, devoid of society, law, and order. Now you play as Walker, the last ranger of the wasteland. Now, you know, I can talk all night.
Was it really
about
Doom?
Guns, the powers you use, the vehicle combat, and of course, you know, the crazy.
I was just asking for confirmation. I didn't know for sure.
You are here to the game.
Before Doom, you might be right with it.
Well, not only do we have Rage 2 playable at our booth at E3,
friggin' Duck Hunt,
but we've got for you an extended look at the world and gameplay of Rage 2. Let's check it out right now.
Yeah.
All right.
Asteroid on a collision course with Earth.
GoldenEye 007, that was a great game. Yeah, keyword was.
80% of the Earth's population.
No, I'm glad you said it, because I was about to.
God turned his back on humanity long ago. Mm-hmm. It wasn't a war. It wasn't global warming. It was a fucking
So apparently
asteroid.
Wolfenstein 3D.
Okay.
Parents murdered.
And
orphan of this wasteland. An army of mutants killed everyone I ever loved.
No. Wolfenstein definitely came first. I remember, Doom used like a different rendering engine to make like more 3D environments.
Yeah. I mean, I was just asking for confirmation. I mean, I'm not denying anything y'all are telling me. I believe you.
I stood by, did nothing. And now, I'm the last ranger of this wasteland. And there's only one thing left to do.
And that is? Rage? Oh, I get it.
Hello, E3, and welcome to the world of Rage 2. In a moment, we'll dive headfirst into
Can someone explain to me exactly what pre-alpha means?
Our main protagonist it just means like, hey, we have the game working.
Aid him in his quest to take down the authority.
Because to be honest, I thought that was alpha. I thought pre-alpha meant you had your polygons and your wires and your platform colors.
I mean, nowadays, though, freaking pre-alpha is basically just like, yes, it's done. I mean, we're ready to ship it. Early access, that crap.
I mean, like, to be honest, because, I don't know, like, maybe all the extra polish is what they really talk about nowadays, but.
Probably.
Like, you have to understand, it goes pre-alpha, then beta, then whatever they want to call it, then we think we're ready, oh shit, we're not, and then the final build.
Doctor, made it to the Space Center.
Keep your wits about you, Walker. The Goon Squad may look whimsical, laughable even, but believe me, behind their playful appearance, they are very, very dangerous.
Before Alpha means before Alpha Sapphire. All right, EDM.
All right.
You can sit down now.
Give that man a 5-minute timeout.
Are you already sitting down? Then yes, you do deserve a 5-minute timeout. Go take your seat and go in the corner, face the wall. Think long and hard about what you did. Come back and never say it again. Forget you said it, but know that you felt bad for 5 minutes because you did something dumb. We just roasted this man for no reason during a Bethesda conference. EDM, I love you. You know I love you.
It mounts on the wall. It's motion sensor activated.
What the fuck? What's up? What the heck? Someone died. RIP. What is happening right now? Dang, it's only 120 bucks. I'm buying one. Aw, you broke it.
Oh wow, I'm actually ahead of you.
Oh really?
Okay, this is actually cool. They have a button on here just to pre-order the game.
Yeah, I saw that. That's pretty neat.
I mean, I'm not going to right now, but that's awesome. Is that like a special Twitch feature that they're getting, or is that something that, you know?
Yeah, it's probably only for like actual developers, because I mean,
hey Twitch,
who's use that though?
Partners could really use something like this, because imagine if we are Amazon associates and we want to promote something like that, and you could just have a little button show up right there. That'd be awesome.
I think they have an extension for that.
You have the Amazon merch store? Yeah, they have extensions, but they don't have pop-up buttons on the stream.
Isn't that what extensions are?
Nah, I think it goes below, like in a panel at the bottom. I could be wrong though, but yeah. Also, now I'm out of Hershey Kisses and I'm sad.
Rip. F in chat for my boy.
F in chat, like on YouTube.
Also for you, there is an extra boon. Something that will make you a veritable superhero.
Elevator still running? So far, so good.
By the way, if you don't put an F in chat to pay respects for my Hershey Kisses, how could you? Or rather, how could you not? How dare you not? And there we go. We get a lot more Fs. I appreciate you. You smart. You loyal. YouTube chat, everyone except the two people who said it, you played yourself. DJ Khaled, another one.
Dude, it's Bane.
That was a fat ass guy in a thong.
Oh yeah.
See, this is what they should have done. Had the band played a song during this. Exactly what you said.
Cause now it works. Now it's not like Omega Cringe. All right, cool. I can't wait for Mad Max 3 to come out.
God damn. I wonder if they're going to announce anything at E3 that's going to come this year.